Hey, what's up, YouTube? It's your girl Sadie's 912 back at y'all again. So, this is an update to my pregnancy video that I posted, I don't even know, about a week ago. So, and I know I got some comments congratulating me, but this video, I did say thank you to some, but some I did not. And I'm sorry about that, so this is my apology about that now. Whew. Reason that I did not say thank you to the rest of the people is because a few days after I posted the video, by the time I think a few people commented, I had already had a miscarriage. So it wasn't that I didn't want to say thank you. I was just feeling like really, really bad. So this is just gonna be about my miscarriage. I'm just trying to smile in order to not cry, because it's still kind of fresh. And I'm gonna like tell you all how I've been feeling lately. Okay, so I found out I was pregnant January the 10th of 2018, obviously, and I think that day I told my husband, and I told his mother too. She made a big deal out of it on the phone, like she was happy and stuff. And the next day, she calls my husband and is like, "Oh, it's too soon," and just being really negative, but. The person that I thought was going to be most negative about it was my mom, because I knew my mom was just like, "Oh, you know, you don't need any more anytime soon." And honestly, I have said for years, even before I had KJ, I had said that my cutoff age was 26 for me. I'm 25. I'll be 26 this year, October the 15th. And honestly, I don't want any more kids after that, because I just want to focus on the kids that I have at that time, raising them, and getting my life in order, saving for retirement and stuff like that. So I really don't want to be later on in life planning for more kids or having more kids unexpectedly and then be like, "Oh, you know, when I'm in my retirement years, I still have kids at home, you know, probably in their teens and whatnot, if not newborns like some people," which everybody has their preference. That's just my preference. I don't want any more kids after 26. I don't want to get pregnant after 26. I just want to be done, you know, and like I said, raising my kids. I was going in for my follow-up. My first ultrasound was on the 1st of February. So my follow-up appointment was going to be, it was going to be March the 5th, I want to say. Well, of course, the baby did not make it that long. They called me that Friday after February 1st, whatever date that is. They called and they said, "Hey, the baby has a slow heartbeat." But that's not what the ultrasound tech had told me during the ultrasound. And I feel like she just said that just not to freak me out. She said, "Oh, your blood vessels are so close, I can't get an accurate heartbeat. I'm sorry, guys." Well, she was lying. The doctor called the next day after the ultrasound and said, "Hey, we're going to need you to come back in next week as soon as possible." So the soonest they had was that Thursday. That Tuesday, well, Monday night going into Tuesday, I got really, really, really sick. And I was like, you know, I noticed that my boobs had stopped tingling or whatever. But not a big deal, I guess. Because with KJ, they didn't tingle as much. I was mainly just sick. With Luke, they tingled like all the time. Like, but every pregnancy is different. So they had told me to come in. So we went in on that Thursday. That next appointment was that Thursday. I don't know the date off the top of my head. Well, I was going on about being sick. So either way, I woke up Tuesday morning. Like I was cramping really bad Monday night. Tuesday morning woke up still cramping, but Tuesday morning in the middle of the night, pretty much in the morning, I started vomiting like all over the place. It got on the carpet. It was all over the bathroom floor, in the toilet, everywhere, just everywhere. It even went on the wall. Like it was terrible. And my husband got up, helped me clean up and everything like that. And I was apologizing because I was just like, this is so gross. Bathroom stinks. And, you know, I threw up the calzone we had had that Monday morning. Well, that Monday for lunch. That was all over the bathroom. So he's like, if you need to go to the ER, let me know so we can go. Because I was like in pain. My stomach was hurting. I was laid down on the floor and everything. And he was like, just let me know if I need to take you to the ER. And I was like, yeah. So got the kids ready, took me to the ER. They were like, oh, maybe it's the flu, maybe you have the stomach bug. So the doctor, we're in there for like 3 hours. First, the doctor says it's, you know, the stomach flu or whatever. But when they initially took my blood at the nurse's station, they were like, yeah, they might do an ultrasound, you know, or whatever, because you are pregnant, blah, blah, blah. Didn't do an ultrasound. So the doctor came in, said it was like he thought it was the stomach flu or stomach bug going around. And then he was like, the thing is, I had had one the month before, which was kind of crazy. In December, I had an actual stomach bug. No, the stomach flu, excuse me. So then on the discharge paperwork, he puts that as hyperemesis of pregnancy, which is excessive vomiting. And I had never heard of anybody having that before. And then he also said it was gastritis, something about the acid in my stomach, and that's why I wasn't able to keep anything down. And they had checked my HCG levels, and I guess because of the fact that they were higher than what they were before, there was nobody worried about that. But I think that really and truly Tuesday is really when I started to kind of like start the symptoms of having a miscarriage, not knowing. So I didn't go to work on Tuesday. I think I went back to work Wednesday, and then I went Thursday. Thursday is when I had the appointment at 8 o'clock in the morning to go and see the doctor. Well, I had some spotting, some pink blood and discharge about this much on Wednesday night, and I was like, this is weird. And but I read online like it's nothing to worry about if it didn't come out of your cervix, but I'm like, you know, I don't know if it came out my cervix or not. So I told the doctor about it Thursday morning. So he was like, we're gonna look first, kind of do like a pap smear or whatever. He's like, well, your cervix is open and now it's brown blood in there, so it's coming from your cervix, which is not a good sign. And I had read the night before that's usually the start of a miscarriage. So get in to do the ultrasound. I already knew the baby was gone as soon as he said that it was brown blood in there and that my cervix was open. I was like, it's gone. So get it in there, checking for a heartbeat. There is no heartbeat. And he also said that he thought that the baby probably had a Down syndrome. He said usually when people's babies have slow heartbeats and the pregnancy continues, it's something wrong with the baby, usually Down syndrome. And I was just, whoo, I started crying immediately. He left out to let me and my husband discuss our options, whether I was gonna leave the baby in me, do a DNC, or do the pill. I have the pills over here. I can't remember the name of it. Metoprolol. I think that's what it's called. I don't want to say it wrong. Misoprolol, whatever. But they also call it Cytotect. So, cried and everything, and I'm like, I'm not leaving a dead baby in my stomach. That's just stupid. So that's not even an option. So it's either gonna be this DNC or the Cytotect. So they were like, he was asking what we were doing in the next 2 weeks. So it was sounding like the DNC wasn't gonna happen like right away. And he was just like, yeah, we asked him what did he think was the best option, and he said the side attack. And I said, okay. So he said you have to do 4 pills vaginally and 4 by mouth. So I was like, okay. Well, Friday, and he said do it on Friday. I was so emotional, I couldn't even go back to work. Like, I was just a mess. Like, my husband's like, you know, suck it up, everything will be okay. Just get it together. Don't walk out of this room, you know, like crying and stuff. But I'm like, you know, I couldn't help it, but cry. Because I'm like, you know, that's a part of me that's gone. And to say that the baby possibly had Down syndrome, like that was really tough. So my husband said that, you know, once the doctor said that everything was good, that we would try again, because really we weren't trying, and it ended up happening. So I felt like that made me feel a little bit better. Friday morning I woke up and I started to, I was bleeding 4 o'clock in the morning. I was like, you know, I start crying then, and I'm like, it's happening, it's happening, without even taking this medicine. And I'm glad I had called in. I was like, I don't think I didn't think I was emotionally ready to go back to work that Friday, so I was like, I can't come in. So they said, okay. So then Friday, about lunchtime, because I was bleeding and cramping like the whole time. About lunchtime, though, I went ahead and, well, my husband took the kids to school. I went ahead and got up, in between, like the pain, took a shower. Then I inserted the side attack because he was saying that it still could, not everything might not come out, you know, even if I miscarry on my own. So to still take the side attack just in case. So I did. I did it vaginally, and it said to wait 8 hours to take the other 4 by mouth. So that's what I did, and I seen the placenta and all of that come out. I don't know if I seen the baby pass or whatever, but either way, it came out. When I went for my follow-up the following Tuesday, she had said, that was this past Tuesday, she said that it was still like a centimeter of blood, so she suggested I do. This time the doctor was a female. She was the same one who actually delivered KJ. She suggested that I do another round of the side attack either Tuesday or Wednesday. Well, Tuesday or Tuesday night. Tuesday morning or Tuesday night. So I went ahead and I took it Tuesday. I went ahead and called in again. I only worked like an hour, because my appointment for that was at 8 as well. Sorry this video is so long. But I'm saying all this to say that we don't plan everything in our lives, and things do happen for a reason. I know that. But it was hard hearing everybody call me and say everything happens for a reason. I know that. And I know God won't put more on me than I can bear. And it's possible that the reason why it happened was because God knew I would not be able to handle a child with Down syndrome. Not saying that I couldn't, because I don't know, you know, but it's possible that maybe I wouldn't have been able to handle it. So maybe that's why the baby did not make it. My due date was 24 September 2018, and had a talk with my husband last night. We had been talking about actually trying again, because that's what he told me at the hospital, and I feel like that's what made me cope with the situation a little bit better. Because within 3 days I felt better. The first 2 days of actually, you know, being in pain and everything, like, was the hardest. But last night he said, yeah, you know, we didn't plan for that child. I'm like, yeah, but at the same time, you telling me after we lost that child that we were gonna try again, I feel like helped me to cope some. And now last night he says he doesn't want to try right now. And it's really hard, excuse me, because now I feel all of those emotions again, being sad and feeling like he doesn't understand, you know, because the male doctor had said we could try again once, you know, the bleeding and everything stopped. And if possible, wait at least one cycle. If you just can't wait, then just come in as soon as you find out you're pregnant so that we can monitor the pregnancy and make sure everything's healthy. And then the other doctor that I seen this past Tuesday was saying that, the one that delivered KJ, she was like, wait 3 cycles. But I just feel like I feel all of those emotions again now. After last night, I was really upset. We were out. I went to the bathroom because I felt like I was about to cry because I felt hurt again. And I know we didn't plan that baby, but and we planned KJ. And we took pills to conceive KJ, and he's like, maybe that's why we lost it too. Because I've never not been on something and just gotten pregnant. But now it's like, okay, don't even touch me, is how I feel like. Because you're telling me if I get pregnant again, you're gonna be upset. And like, I don't know. If any of you have felt how I feel right now or have gone through a miscarriage, I'm sorry for your loss. Comment, rate, subscribe. I will be doing more videos and updating you all on how I feel. It's kind of hard right now to talk to my family about it just because I feel like my mom didn't want me to have another kid in the first place. And neither did my brother. My dad was okay with it. My dad's a preacher, so if I ever need uplifting words, I call my dad. My dad is not judgmental and everything like that either. But it just hurts feeling all those emotions again. I guess I kind of feel like I'm not wanted. Not saying that my husband doesn't want me, but at the same time, that's how it feels. Because you're like, if you get pregnant again, I'm gonna be upset because it wasn't planned. I don't know. I just would have rather we agreed on something. I'm the type of person, if you tell me that we're gonna do something, that's what I go with. So when you tell me something different, I initially really get upset. So, I haven't really talked to him much today, just because I don't feel like it. And I had already started the pre-mama fertility stuff. And then I also was taking the same thing that I conceived with KJ on, which was a fertility blend that you can get at GNC, because that's how we conceive KJ. And, I had bought his as well again, so I'm like, I wasted my money, and like now I just feel like, why don't you go buy some condoms and use those? But at the same time, I don't feel like I want him to even touch me. After seeing that last night, and I just told him at the table, I said, well, I'm gonna be honest with you. If that's the case, you don't want any more kids right now, if it does not happen before my birthday, I don't want any kids. I don't want any more. I want you to go and get fixed so that you can get me pregnant. Yeah. So, like I said, if you've ever felt this way, comment below. If you've went through a miscarriage, comment below. If you've had a miscarriage and then conceived right after, comment below. I was hoping to be one of those people that would have a miscarriage. Well, not hoping to have a miscarriage. I'm saying since the miscarriage, hoping that after I would get pregnant, you know, within the first month of trying. Like I've seen some people on YouTube and had successful pregnancies. I was hoping to be one of those women and to be able to do my video and update you all saying, hey, I had a miscarriage and I'm pregnant again. But I guess I won't be. And so now he's wanting to talk about everything, you know, saying we should talk about everything. He wants to take me out tomorrow. I really don't even want to go. So, yeah. You all tell me what you think. Don't forget, rate, comment, and subscribe. And yeah, I'll see y'all in the next one. Bye.